Congratulate Fusion and Michelle for everything that we've done so far here over the past years. And for those of you that know Michelle, she's a very special woman. She's very special to me and to, I think, everyone here. And I'm just so happy to be part of everything that Fusion has to offer. So thank you, Michelle. Well, without further ado, I'll invite up Michelle, and thank you very much.
I know I feel very far away from you guys. Could I ask those of you that aren't eating to just kind of come out? I like closeness. I want to see your face. Just stand up here in the shade. Thank you. Thank you. And what about the prime ministers? Let's give it up for the music. Great band. Free CDs over here, by the way. Anybody who wants the music is over here. Take a CD. Well, I want to thank you guys all for coming. This is a very, very special time in the history of Fusion, and I'm very proud and honored to be standing before you today. We're all here to celebrate the future of education. And I want to thank the Solana Beach Chamber, who's here tonight to help us celebrate. Thank you very much. Where are you guys? There you guys are, Solana Beach. I very much would like to thank Katrina Glenn, who has worked for weeks and weeks to pull this event off. Katrina, you've done a marvelous job. And of course, a shout out to my very good friends at American Education Group who flew out for this event. Thank you, Jeff, Steve, wherever you are. Thank you. Now, my PR girls asked that I give a brief speech. Obviously, they don't know me very well. I will tell you that I wrote an initial speech to give tonight that I could not get through without crying. So I deleted it and started over. So here you go. I can't promise you I'm not still going to cry. We're all here tonight to celebrate the future of education, and specifically the exciting future of alternative education in America and Fusion's role in shaping it. But before we can look to our very bright future, it's important to take a moment and remember where we came from. 22 years ago, I was a fresh-faced 21-year-old. Yes, I just gave away my age. Straight out of college, armed with a special ed teaching credential and ready to change the world. I was so excited the morning of my first day of teaching in a public school in Brandon, Florida. Now, if you don't know where Brandon is, that's a good thing. I walked in to my classroom trailer, and the first thing I noticed is that there was no windows, and that, of course, should have been my first clue. My class of 20 severely emotionally disturbed kids started streaming into class, and as I'm awaiting my teacher's aide, the principal comes in to tell me that there's not going to be one this year. It was at that moment that I said to myself, "Self, we're not changing the world this way." Forward a few years later to California, and after a stream of experiences, I find myself tutoring at-risk kids out of a guest office in my home. It was this time that I met my personal mentor, Dr. Sarah Frampton, who is here tonight, who saw something in me that I hadn't seen in myself, and she believed in something that she saw. Sarah taught me that with a combination of confidence, extremely hard work, perseverance, and a touch of moxie, more than a touch of moxie, that anything was possible. It was then that I realized three important things. Number one, that I wanted nothing more than to mentor and help young adults find their light as she had helped me. Two, I would never work for a system that didn't work again. And three, changing the world was not a crazy goal, but really should be the only goal. Thank you, Sarah. You taught me all of those things. Thank you so much. And before I go on, I know that Dr. Frampton would like to come up and just say a few brief words, and then I'll resume this.
I don't know about brief. I don't know if I do brief well. Now, I'm reaching down here. Everybody who's a female knows what you keep down here. You keep the few words you're going to say. I am totally surprised and very grateful to Michelle for her kind words. Totally caught off guard. I had no idea she was going to be saying anything like this tonight. But I have a couple of things to say about her program here and her, because I have walked a long road of looking for resources for kids who don't seem to fit in the niche. Not that they're square pegs for round holes, but that they need something different on the continuum that the system isn't providing. And that's what Michelle has done. So I free associated for about 4 minutes in my office today because I didn't have a lot of time and came up with a few thoughts I want to share with you. I knew Michelle when she first came. Yes, I don't know how we met, but she was trying to do something to help kids, and that's how it happened. I believe she has saved the lives of wonderful young people who had no other place to go. Many of those were my clients, and for that I'm very grateful. I think what Fusion is, it's a vision coming out of a critical need. All of us can look around now and see needs, but it takes a real gift to translate a critical need into something that can work. She didn't have a big funding source. She didn't have planners or business advisors. She started in her garage in her home and translated that into touching so many lives over the years. It's gratifying to me to have been even a little part of that. Michelle has had the training and sensitivity to make her vision translate into the Fusion program with nickels and dimes and using her wits. She has mentored and coached Fusion like a mother does a child, and she has done the same for the staff, the parents, and the teachers. I have known her for 20 years. She's beautiful, smart, but she's a tough gal, and that's my kind of person. Her gift is seeing a need and finding the resources to make it happen. I don't think Fusion will be her last mark. I thank her for this, and I look forward to her developing her other insights and gifts into things that will continue to help students. We celebrate this day with Michelle, and we all celebrate her. Thank you. She's useless now. She's crying. I think we should all have a drink.
The roots of Fusion took hold 20 years ago, first in a guest room working one-on-one with tutoring students, and then in my garage converted school room where I hired my very first employee, Karina Neal. Karina, where are you? Who is still here with us today. Thank you, girl. I stole her away from med school, by the way. When we discovered that traffic control was needed on my residential street, we moved Fusion to an office in Cardiff. At that point, we had a total of 6 employees, 3 of which are still Fusion faculty. Our stint in Cardiff was rapid, as Fusion continued to grow at a tremendous rate, and it was then, 8 years ago, that we moved to Solana Beach. The support of the San Diego community was overwhelming. Our students were flourishing and our families were grateful for all that we were doing for their kids. We were tutoring and mentoring over 200 students annually, but one thing was still missing. We still tutored some kids that no matter what we did, no matter how hard we worked, still were not thriving in traditional schools. We knew then what we had to do. There's absolutely no question. We opened our doors to our first high school student 8 years ago. We modeled our school around the needs of our students who could not find success in traditional educational models. What did they need? How could they find success? And most importantly, what did we need to be to help them find that success? We knew we couldn't ask them to fit into a one-size-fits-all model of school. So we created an individual school experience around each and every student. Every schedule was different. Every hour of instruction was custom tailored to the specific needs of each student, and every child had their own set of goals that they worked toward.